आई एम सी पी तलेसरा, चेयरमैन एक्सलेंस अवार्ड कमिटी. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस वेबिनार ऑन यूसीआई एक्सलेंस अवार्ड्स रोड टू एक्सलेंस. थ्रू दिस वेबिनार वी विल टेक यू थ्रू अ विजन ऑफ अवार्ड्स, कैटेगरी ऑफ अवार्ड्स, एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया, जूरी पैनल, द अवार्ड प्रोसेस, प्रोसीजर फॉर इवेल्युएशन एंड द ट्रांसपेरेंसी वी मेंटेन. All these points would be dealt by Mr. Manish Kodha, who has been deeply involved in the award process for last 3 years. Also, I would like to state that we have simplified the process for filing details in 2 stages. Stage 1 is basic information and describing your strength and claims for the award. Everyone qualifying through stage 1 shall be requested to apply in stage 2 form, which shall be more detail and shall have all information required by jury for proper evaluation. I am privileged to quote the words of Mr. N.K. Pandey, a past president of IIT Delhi Alumni Association, regarding the road to excellence. He says that, and I repeat this verbatim, applying for excellence awards would be beneficial to every applicant who fills in the expression of interest. Even though the final stage of selection may be a little further ahead, it would be the first worthy step in your road to excellence. By answering the questions in the application form itself, the applicant becomes aware of the subtle requirements in overall management of the organization, of various processes and procedures required to steer the organization towards sustained excellence. Since achieving excellence has no shortcuts, the applicant, by virtue of participating in this process, sets his organization on the journey towards excellence. The applicant becomes a part of larger ecosystem striving for excellence, including peers, mentors, and the jury members. Undoubtedly, the long-term benefits will be felt by the participating organizations through continuing interactions with the peers and mentors throughout the process of the Excellence Awards, as well as beyond the award ceremony in the years to come. I shall now pass on for further proceedings to Mr. Manish Kodha for carrying forward this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, Teresa sir, and welcome everyone to this webinar. Teresa sir mentioned in the agenda, we will be running you through some of the aspects of the award process and the eligibility criteria, and try to answer any questions that you might have. Before I start, perhaps it would be a good idea if you can indicate if I am completely audible, if there is any disturbance, or if you are facing any issues. Please put if you have any problems on the chat window. The team would be able to address it quickly. Great. Thank you. The first thing that we would want to emphasize, and that was something that Alyssa sir also mentioned, is why UCCI Excellence Awards? What's the vision towards it? What's the vision which UCCI has towards creating this as an institution? Now, one of the key things that UCCI strives for is obviously the growth and sustainability of the industry in the South Rajasthan, in the Udaipur region. And towards that, the idea is that business excellence is very important, and awards would allow us to create an endeavor, an initiative for measuring and recognizing excellence. And what that would allow us as a community, as a business community, to learn from each other, to share our experiences, our knowledge, and inspire each other, inspire the businesses in this area for sustained, enduring growth. So with that idea, with that as a vision, we have focused on measuring the excellence. Now, excellence, of course, can mean different things for different people, but then we have tried to think in terms of what business excellence actually means, how can we measure it, and how can that measurement itself drive the right kind of business behavior, which would lead towards excellence. So this virtuous cycle of measurement, sharing, learning, and recognition that comes from rewards itself, as you apply, as you participate in this, that virtuous cycle is what this entire effort, the UCCA Excellence Awards, is about. So as this has been established, the UCCA Excellence Awards have been in these nine categories. As you can see, those categories are relating to services as an industry type. Yes. So services as an industry type are in three categories: small enterprises, large enterprises, and medium enterprises. Then we also, in order to recognize effort in the area of corporate social responsibility, there is a CSR award. Then there are four awards in the manufacturing sector for the companies or businesses in the manufacturing sector: micro, small, medium, and large. And we also have this category which was introduced last year, which is social enterprise award. So we will be talking a bit about that. These awards have been sponsored by our generous sponsors, who have been an integral part of this journey to excellence: Mewa Politics, GR Infra Project, Gate, Single Foundation, and Wonder Cement.
Thank you to all of them.
Thank you. So this journey towards excellence. And here are the last year's winners. And many of these winners are companies which are new, companies which are very small, companies who have done very innovative work, and also companies which are pretty established. So these awards have been able to cover a wide variety of businesses in a very different ways. And I would also point this thing out, that all of these winners last year, they won for the first time. So that shows that the culture of excellence is becoming more and more widespread. More and more people are coming in, and this is actually instilling a very healthy inspiration to all the companies. For any awards of this kind, it is important that the process is transparent. So we would be talking about the process today. We would be talking about how this entire process of evaluating and ranking and everything goes about. But then this entire process, very importantly, is moderated, is managed, and is determined by our esteemed jury. And the jury, as you can see, which comprises of very eminent people who have been in leadership positions in academia, in business, in government, in CSR field, in professional services field, they really represent the best amongst us. They represent the kind of thinking that we all strive for. So Anil Vaishsav, he is a highly experienced and very learned person. He has agreed to be part of the jury. Shri Akhilesh Joshi, he has led Hindustan Zinc ably. He has very, very rich experience of managing large enterprises, all aspects of business. Professor Janak Shah, director of IIM Udaipur, represents the best in class in terms of knowledge and for the businesses. Nilima Khetan, ma'am, she has been heading CSR, and she has provided us very different perspectives about how do we look at companies, how do we look at various aspects within the company. And Shobhit Ji, he comes from KPMG, is a partner there in consulting services. He has brought in the knowledge of how companies can improve themselves. And so the combined wisdom of all of these people have been put in as we decided on the criteria, as we decided on the process, and when these people, they look at the companies, they look at all the aspects that are relevant for business excellence. Now, very quickly, as we talk about the awards, the first part, of course, is the eligibility part. This is an award, excellence awards for businesses. So, of course, all business organizations in whatever form they are organized, they could be companies, other body corporates. So let's say a business is organized as a society, some healthcare or education organizations could be that. So any body corporate, partnership firms, proprietorship firms, LLPs, in any ways, any business has been organized. But then we do try to ensure that a business is a going concern and is having an independent books of accounts that are under the standard Indian accounting standard, so they can be evaluated, compared, and so on. And they have to be ongoing businesses in the sense must have ongoing operations as of today, as well as have been in business, have been having revenues for last 2 years as well. And these awards, as the UCCI's sphere is for the businesses located in these 8 districts of Rajasthan, the South Rajasthan districts, as they have been listed there. That does not essentially limit any company which is registered outside of these districts to participate. They can participate. But the only condition is that the main or the key, some of the key operating units, whether manufacturing units or service delivery units, they are there in this district. So they must have presence, good substantial presence in this area. We, as you would have seen, there are 4 size classifications in each of the sectors: small, medium, micro, large. Those have been decided as per the MSME, the Government of India's MSME norms. That those are exactly the same for manufacturing sector. For the services sector, since the dynamics of service sector are a little bit different, so we have taken micro as it is defined as small, and small as medium, and rest as large. So in services, we have 3 categories. So here's the important part. This is something that that we have carefully designed to ensure fullest of transparency and fullest of fairness as we determine the awards. The first step, of course, is the finalization of categories and criteria. That has been done. That has been identified based on the awards committee as well as the executive committee. They came together, they decided on the awards, looked at the sponsors and the entire process. So that's the first step that has been done. The second step, which has been introduced this year, is expression of interest and collection of basic information about the business, which is for all the eligible business that we have just talked about, and that has been there online. We might do a quick demo of that as needed. So that's the process that is going on. The last date for this process is 10th of February, and it is a very small, simple form which should not take a lot of time. It does not really require you to pull up your books of accounts or anything. So it's a straightforward form which can be filled very easily. We encourage every one of you to quickly go to the UCCI's website and look at the.
Are you doing the demo now?
So it's right here. If you have looked at the site, apply here is the category, is the on the UCCI site. So what's
Manishji is now going to run you through how to fill the stage one form. Stage one form is now on the screen. The moment you press the apply now button, the stage one form comes onto your screen.
So this only requires you to take in very, very basic information about your company's name, your own name.
You just fill in a dummy name.
So
please go ahead. Company name is a good company. The name of the applicant who is filling in the form, not the company name, the person who is filling in the form. Then next is his designation. Then the email address on which you would like to you would expect correspondence from the UCCI Awards Process Committee. and then your address. ABC, plot number, whatever, Madhavi Industrial Area, Bilwada, Udaipur, whatever. Then so, your GST number, if you have one. GST number is not compulsory if you do not have the number. The next comes is the Udyog Aadhaar Memorandum number, which some enterprises may not have. So even that is an optional number, but whosoever has needs to fill in the number.
So, and the other part is, are you a UCCA member? So this is an important thing to recognize, that these awards are not limited to UCCA members only. These are for businesses in this region. And so anybody in this area should be able to join it and participate in the awards.
The reason for filling in the particular category, whether you are a UCCA member or not, is just to register how many non-members are participating in the awards. It has nothing to do with who will qualify to win the awards. Then comes to an award category, wherein the applicant can, by his own judgment, think whether he is in manufacturing, services, CSR. There could be some applicants who are in both the sectors, manufacturing as well as services. You could fill up whatever you feel like. The auditing committee will decide as to what is your prominent field and then reclassify you based on their judgment. If necessary, they will call you and check out after you fill up the stage 2 form.
So we'll have two different forms. So that would happen.
Yeah.
And so the CSR award category is for any business, whether it's manufacturing or services or anything. This is for any good CSR initiative that you might have taken.
A clarification on CSR. Very important clarification. Normally, people would assume that CSR is something which is meant for those companies who are bound to do a CSR from the Government of India criteria, the income tax criteria, having 1,000 crores turnover or at least 250 employees or something like that, those whatever criteria are there. But no, in this case, CSR for these awards is any company, small or large, doing any kind of corporate social responsibility work. The definition of corporate is not, has nothing to do with turnovers.
So a business which is involved in CSR activities and has a specific project or projects, they can apply for CSR category award.
That's right, Manish.
So that is there. Social enterprise, we will define it a little bit. It's a different kind of a business which we want to recognize. Udaipur has very prominently emerged as a social capital, social enterprise capital in the country. So we have created this as a special category here. So you can choose whatever that
you would like to clarify, that a company can apply only for one of the awards.
One can apply for a CSR award.
Could be for more. Yeah, please. Click.
One can apply for CSR award and any other category.
Okay, so CSR is one category, separate category, and the other 8 awards are all one category. So one could apply for any one of the 8 awards and CSR also.
Okay, and then of course, based this information, we ask for determining which category that you fall in terms of the MSME classification. So please do put in whatever is your capital investment and turnover numbers which are there. And then we
just
are
asking... Second, Manishi, I will just intervene here. Mm-hmm. This classification of MSME and services category is as per the MSME criteria of Government of India existing prior to the budget 2021. It means that whatever has happened in the budget, whatever stipulated relaxations in the budget for category changes or classification are not going to be applicable for these awards, as we are looking at performance ended March 2020. Okay. So do not need to worry about what the government has done in the budget as regards categorization of industries.
So then comes there are two qualitative or subjective questions that we have. The reason for that, and as Talisa Saab also mentioned, that is where you start looking at your business from benchmarking and from an excellence point of view. So the idea is that you can... that you can identify what are the key strengths strengths of your organization, and now those are your product uniqueness.
Sorry to interrupt you, but you missed out 2 points which you have to fill up. Fill up the criteria, the category of the investment amount. I've done that. I'm not able to see that. And I filled up there. Between 1 crore and 10 crore. So what you have to do is that you're not supposed to declare your turnover. You are supposed to declare the bracket of your turnover. So if some company is doing, say, maybe 2.3 crores, then they have to declare between 1 crore to 10 crores. And if suppose the investment is, where is the investment?
The first part is investment, the second part is turnover.
So if suppose the turnover is, 25 lakhs, then you would put up into the category of turnover which is covering 25 lakhs. If it is at 250 crores and more, say maybe the turnover is 330 crores, then you just stick the amount about 250 crores. And that's how you go to the next item, that is mention at least 3 key strengths. Please, Manish, carry on.
So here the idea is that, and that is something that would determine how we move an application to the next stage, as well as that would be something that would be given to the jury to judge and decide their criteria on. But then the request here is not to really think too much about it, but then to identify what clearly are your business strengths. They could be related to your product, they could be related to your services, they could be related to your specific innovation, pricing, quality, or the kind of people that you have.
So, she kindly enter 3 USPs of a good company.
So,
which you are
filling up. We will run it out. We won't really submit.
No. It's okay.
So fine. So I think because fine, it would just be a little descriptive something. One can put in a qualitative thing. And similarly, when the next question is about what are the key achievements? Now the reason we are asking here is that these awards are for current performance. So
up to March 20.
So we request here what could be the key aspects or key performance aspects that you might have. Some of you might want to talk about the revenue growth that you might have. Maybe you have won an award somewhere. Maybe you have achieved a new technology adoption that you might have done. Maybe you have added a quality management system. So there could be anything, but then what is the highlight achievement of the last year, if you can compare? Here we definitely ask for your mobile number. We would request an OTP and then the base.
What's the number?
Based on
that. So you type your mobile number here, the relevant mobile number for which you have a control, 60905. Then as soon as you press it, then you request for the OTP, click the request OTP button, and you get the OTP, the number is 1176. Put in the OTP here and submit.
So this allows you to submit the form. So as you can see, this form is simple, but at the same time thought-provoking, and that's the entire idea of this process.
Right. So Manishji, thank you for running through the stage one form. I suppose it has been informative for all the participants. We have some 36 participants I can see on the screen. And maybe supported by a team of people on every screen. So we are happy to note that something like 40 or 50 people are at least participating in the webinar right now. The webinar is being recorded, and the recording will be available on YouTube or some other appropriate forum for people to review and continue to answer question and answers. Now, if there is something in which CPSA would like to add or Manishji would like to add, they can add. And after that, we'll get into the question and answer session. So
there are quite a few things.
Right. Please go ahead.
So this is the second stage in the awards process, as you can see. The expression of interest and basic information. those would be vetted by the awards evaluation subcommittee within UCCI, which also has external members and jury is guiding it through, that would allow for a filtering. And based on that filtering, a set of people would be invited for stage two application. Stage two application is a detailed information collection, and UCCI has also arranged for a mentorship and an assistance cell, which would allow you to fill that form as well as identify if there are any things relevant to your business that you might want. So we have actually for all the aspects of the form identified what are the best practices, resources, and all of that information is available within UCCI to help you through the detailed information.
This cell will become active the moment stage two form is launched.
Stage two form is launched. So that would be by invitation, a subset of first stage applicants would go into the second stage. The second stage applicants, once the forms have been collected, detailed information has been collected, an independent auditor would be compiling all the information, checking it against the financial statements and so on, and will be doing a complete detailed tabulation and ranking and shortlisting based on objective evaluation. We would be talking about the criteria in a bit, but then the idea is that it would be done purely on objective basis based on the information that has been collected by an independent auditor. The UCCI executive committee as well as the subcommittee is not involved in doing any of that. This is entirely based on the information that is submitted and evaluated by the auditor.
Manishia, let me interrupt here. See, it has been noticed, observed enough that some people carry a misapprehension that these awards are meant for a few people who have large and a number of employees, people who are very capable, people who can fill up the forms, etc. And the small people, the small enterprises do not have any chance. The fact that the small enterprises like Rishabh Travels, Silas, I would not say small in any other sense, in a demeaning sense, but small in a normal sense of MSME and a categories. And there are so many of them who have received the awards last year and in the last 4 years put together. So that should be enough reason for people to consider and think that they will become eligible. And if they go, they take the first step, then probably the last step will be visible.
So there is specific categories for small and micro enterprises, size businesses. So the that would keep on happening. And then after the tabulation and the ranking that has happened, based on that ranking, a short list of a few companies in each of their categories is taken, and that is subjected to a further due diligence and site visits. The site visits have been suggested by the jury for identifying certain specific information about the business owners, business management, business site, and so on. And so that would be carried on by the UCC executive and the awards committee of the shortlisted. So it would be adequately informed in advance, and then a visit would be planned. All of that information, the objective information that has been collected in stage two, the site visit information, the basic information that has been collected for all the shortlisted companies is presented to the jury for final evaluation and awards determination. That is a closed room deliberation done by the jury members themselves to identify. And then that's where the final awards are determined. So that's the entire process, which has been very carefully right.
Manish, if I may interrupt you, Manish, just to say one thing, that this process by under which the shortlisting is done, the auditor tabulates and presents the information on an anonymous basis. So the information provided by the applicants is completely confidential and is not disclosed. कि ये इंफॉर्मेशन इस कंपनी की है ये किसी हालत में पता नहीं पड़ता है. ऑडिटर उसको एनोनिमाइज कर देता है और उस एनोनिमस लिस्ट के बेसिस पे शॉर्टलिस्टिंग होता है और एनोनिमस लिस्ट ही जूरी के पास जाती है.
एग्जैक्टली, थैंक यू. सो going ahead, I would very quickly go ahead. What are the criteria that jury uses as well as the auditor uses to compute the...
How much time will you take for?
5-7 minutes.
Okay, Manish will gonna conclude his work, his part on another 5-7 minutes. Then the room will be open for question and answers.
So as you can see, the criteria, the evaluation criteria is pretty exhaustive in terms of various aspects of business. All those aspects have been accounted for. We start from looking at an overall management. Are there people who are the people involved in the management? What's the company vision? How it is organized? The financial outcomes, including the growth rates, growth rate of revenues, growth rate of EBITDA, returns on capital employed, and so on. We also look at and compute the HR and operational aspects, including the aspects of safety and environment record, training and development efforts, and so on. Then innovation, we pick it up from the balance sheet as well as what has been reported, how much of the new innovation the company has been able to put in business, and also the social responsibility part as a small part, even for a larger category. And we also look at in today's world, market presence, online and offline, is very important. What's the online efforts that the company is making? So we also look at that. In the services, the criteria is similar, but then they have been tweaked to focus more on how services organization work. For example, looking at purely EBITDA or turnover or return on capital. So we are focusing on things like average revenue per employee and so on. Then comes the social enterprise. Social enterprise is a different kind of a business, which is what we define as social enterprise, as a profit-making organization, an organization for profit, but its primary goal is not just commercial, but then primary goal is to benefit society in general. So there are quite a few such kind of an organizations that have come up in our area, and for them there is a different set of criteria. In this case, we are not really looking at profits generated, but then how efficiently organization is using its resources. For CSR, again, there is an extensive criteria. One set of criteria is for the company. What is the kind of governance structure that the company has for the CSR aspects? Is there a review process? How they are looking at the outcomes? And then we also look at the specific project that the company has reported. What has been the quality of that project? What has been the impact, and so on? And this criteria has been determined by our jury members as well as people from the nonprofit sector. That's about it.
Okay. Thank you, Manish ji. It's been a very informative presentation from you, and I think the members who have participated in this webinar would definitely find it very informative and would have clarified a lot of questions in their minds. At this stage, I would like to make one or two comments on the awards. One is that the jury would look into whether there is sufficient competition in individual categories and would like to take an informed judgment as to what is to be done in case there is low competition. At this stage, I would like to urge all the large companies to consider and apply. What we have found is that large companies sometimes feel that UCCI awards still do not merit their attention. It is my humble submission that your participation encourages us to be more bold and to be more expansive, to increase our width of reach. Similarly, we also found that there are some people who would have questions about the awards. In view of the COVID and the issues, this time the awards have been delayed. We have launched them only in the month of February first week. Therefore, although the committee wanted to do a lot of work The committee itself got initiated only in the month of January, towards the end of December. So we would like to humbly submit that, broadly speaking, the parameters which have been there until now have not been changed. And only where it is expressly required to change the parameters, the committee is intervening. Rest of the parameters continue to be what they have been in the past. It is for your information that I would like to announce.
We have received some feedback from the jury members in the past, and those feedback have been incorporated in the process.
I am pleased to announce that Shri Sanjay Singhal sir of Secure Meters has taken the onus of developing a black book on the awards. It will be a complete guide document which will be ready for the next year awards. It will be a process which will probably take him about 4 to 6 months, supported by many other people. But we hope that he will be able to bring it to a conclusion before the next year's award process begins. With that, I would like to open the room for questions. Anyone who would like to ask any questions is welcome to. We unmute the meeting to everyone. You can either unmute your own button and begin, or you can maybe send a chat and we will unmute your button. Thank you. Manishji, can you unmute all?
There are already few chats which you need to answer.
Chats. Can you see the chats? Yeah, Manishji is addressing the chats. He's
okay.
I'm not sure if I am able to look at specific questions.
Can you repeat? Can you address them? Can you read out the question which you can read?
I can.
Yeah, please read out the question.
Okay. He says, would you like to present our work? Then it would be easy for us and for you too. So, do you allow some companies' work to be presented?
Okay, Manishji, can I could probably answer this question better?
So the process of awards would involve, after the evaluation of the objective, the basic criteria, would involve site visits and people from the committee visiting the company. And in that situation, the expectation, of course, is that that company makes a case for winning the awards, and that would be duly recorded and minuted for the purpose of jury deliberations. So that would definitely be there. At the same time, people who are companies and businesses which have been shortlisted, we would be actually taking a small introduction from them, a presentation from them, which would be put on the website, as well as the program of that day would unfold. We would include some aspects about the shortlisted company in the on the award day itself. So there would definitely be both a lot of visibility for the shortlisted companies, as well as opportunity to present oneself.
Yes, Anshul, can you read out the second?
Is Nidhi, are you there?
This is
a question from Nidhi. Are you there, Nidhi?
Doesn't matter, you can address the question.
Okay, no problem. Okay, Komal has something to say. Go ahead.
Yes, Komalji.
President sir wants to say something.
Hey, not as a president, as a basic question which I had. Can you hear me?
Yeah, please go ahead.
The basic question which I had was, what is, whenever you have an evaluation criteria, the jury would give some score, is it?
Yes. So they would not be giving scores. The scores would be given in the process of tabulation. So those.
Yeah, okay. So what I want to say, considering the situation of COVID and 9 awards, number of participants, I think in each category, minimum number of applicant has to be specified, say that 3, 4, anything like that. Or even if there is one applicant, he becomes excellent.
So that is something that we would leave for the jury to decide if they believe there is sufficient competition in a particular category. In a particular category, we would
be. There is one applicant only. Maybe very good.
We have not given an award.
I'm not going to give you size. I think we'll tell you.
Haji,
yeah, we have not given award when there is only one applicant. Or
so what is the minimum number of applications we should have in a category?
So we will deliberate on this, and maybe it will be minimum 5, but maybe even 10. So the committee will deliberate, and then the jury will take a call on this.
Okay, right. I mean, that was one basic thing, because the competition is low. Would still the award in that category will be considered or not? That was my question.
No, if the competition is not sufficient in the eyes of jury, the award will not.
Sir, we may want to merge. The jury may want to merge the applicants, the low number of applicants into the other category, if they feel it right. There is a question on the chat box. Can Manish address it?
So there is a question that can I apply for social enterprise if they have done social work with reputed NGO? The difference that we have to highlight here is a social enterprise award is for a company or a business where the one of its main goal is social benefit.
Yeah,
so that's the it's for that. A company which is an essentially a for-profit company, and is the main goal of the company is goods or products or services in the commercial sector, and it does social work, then it should go into CSR category. What is the main objective of your business? If it is social good, then it goes into social enterprise. If not, you can apply in the CSR category. The other question that is there is that there are six, we have 6 units across India, and sure. So the other question is, they have 6 units across India, and whether the performance of one Udaipur unit would be taken into account or the entire company put together. The accounting unit is taken into account, the for which the books of accounts are available. So typically it's the entire company. So the performance of the entire company is taken into account. Being in Udaipur area is only an eligibility criteria.
Yeah, thank you. Manishji, may I request you to transfer the host to our control room at UCPI so that they can take questions from people who are available. Just leave the host.
Can I, Manish, one of the important things which you needed to have said.
Sir, you can please go ahead. We are able to hear you.
Okay. Ek cheez jo batani aavashyak thi, award jab khatam ho jate hain, award ki process khatam ho jati hai, winner decide ho jata hai, to jo log shortlist hue, unko ek feedback jata hai, which in you may not have won an award, you get the opportunity to learn from your peers ki hame kahan apne business ko strengthen karna hai, hame kahan hamari strength hai, kahan hamari weakness hai, hum kis pe work karein. And that feedback is again something very, very important for businesses to get better as they go forward. As long as people understand that this is not just seeking recognition, but it is also an opportunity to improve. That's what this award process does.
Yeah. In fact, Sanjay Saab, I would add there, it's not just for the shortlisted candidate. We have,
everybody.
We have asked, given that quote based on the anonymized data to all the eligible participants. That report, which benchmarks one's own performance against all the other companies in the category, that has been shared with. So that is a deliverable that we would have this time as well, and very useful by people who received it.
Yeah, now one feedback to all the participants is that UCCI, I mean the awards committee, has developed a feedback form which will be put up on the website by in the next 1 hour. You can submit your issues, questions, or any other feedback in about 100 words so that the committee can address your queries or whatever concerns you have regarding the awards. Thank you.
Okay. So there are a couple other things you could write down it on the chat window. So there are a couple of other questions. As this question is added, we can take that up. One is people who want to apply for CSR as well as for the services or manufacturing category twice. So there will be two applications in those cases.
May I clarify? In stage one, you can apply for any categories. We will scrutinize these categories and we will guide you as to which category you should apply in before you want to fill up the stage two form.
No, it's a different question.
Okay.
If you have to apply for CSR as well, please apply it separately. So that's for the was a question. The another was
that is applicable for first stage also. I mean, again, apply one more.
Yes, for first stage also, please put in two, because those would be the CSR applications are handled separately from stage zero.
We are pleased to inform that we have over 100 applications already till yesterday. Tomorrow evening or day after when we close. There is a question there. So I am not a member of UCCI, but we want to present our work in front of your team. You are most welcome.
The process is the same whether you are a member of UCCI or not.
For the information of all those who are there on the webinar, something like 60,000 email addresses have been, and I sent the emails for informing them about the awards. And these 60,000 come from all the list of members who are registered through DICs, RICO, and across these 8 districts. Apart from that, the awards have been publicized widely across social media platforms like WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, and many other blogs. We are again emphasizing the fact that every single enterprise who is doing legal business for revenue, for profit, is eligible for applying in these awards, be it service sector, be it industry, manufacturing sector. You could be as small as in having invested 5 lakh rupees, you could be as small as having a turnover of 5-10 lakh rupees. The minimum turnover, the minimum investment is not a criteria at all. Thank you.
Sir, Vinod ji.
Yes, Vijay ji, batai.
I am applying only for increasing the application numbers. Since I know that I cannot get the award, even then I am applying. So sir, all the members of the executive committee at least should be conveyed that they should apply. So, last year also.
I would want to answer that. If any one of you has a to win the awards because the criteria is this and that, I would want to put across two benefits that they would have in any case. One is that they would be considering their business in a very standardized, in a very comprehensive fashion, that itself would make a big difference to their businesses. Secondly, as Sanjay Saab also mentioned, we would be sharing a benchmarking report based on their data to them, which would allow them to see things like companies of their size in their area, how much they are spending on R&D, for example. Now, that is a great kind of an information to have. So there would be a benefit, even if you believe the...
Let me put in my thoughts on this. Aisa hai, Vijay ji, Goda sahab, humare vice president sahab, this is the road to entrepreneurship. And jo logon ne salaam karna chahenge, un sabko pranam karna chahenge, aapne ye karya kiya. क्योंकि जिंदगी में बहुत कम ही लोग होते हैं जो एंटरप्रेन्योर की राह पर चलते हैं और आपने वो साहसी कदम उठाया है, तो क्यों ना आप जो है फॉर्म भर करके और आगे का एक अगला कदम उठाएं, जिससे आज नहीं तो कल कहीं ना कहीं आप भी जो है उदयपुर साउथ राजस्थान के पटल पर कहीं एक बुलंद सितारे की तरह चमकने शुरू हो जाए. थैंक यू. एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस? We have completed about 55 minutes. we would like to maybe spend another 2-3 minutes. If President Sir, Kothari Sir would like to speak on this, on the awards or any other issues or any other thoughts he has, we would like him to chip in. Meanwhile, if you have any more questions, we will address them and try to close this webinar in the next 2-3 minutes.
Thank you, Vinodji. I would like to place my sincere appreciation for the chairman, co-chairman, award committee and the committee members for putting in all vigorous efforts in the circumstances we are actually working. But I'm very happy that things have been put into shape. A lot of clarity has been brought, and after a lot of deliberations, things have been made clear who can participate. Nidhi had a question which I was not very clear whether it has been answered well or not. She wanted to present the work on this webinar, or you want to present to the committee otherwise, which she can answer in the chat. But I would like to place
I have on a private message.
Private message likh dijiye.
But I would also like to address it to all the participants that this webinar is not supposed to present for presenting your performance or anything, because we are not the jury. So if you have to present your performance, then you will have to first qualify from stage 1, get into stage 2, and then if there is after the audit, if you require a hand. They are getting to the choice set, then the executive committee members or some team would go to those individual enterprises and see firsthand what they are doing, and that is the time for demo. That will be the time for Nidhi to answer and to showcase her whatever she has done. Is that clear? Yeah. Thank you, Nidhi.
Thank you, sir.
To finally sum up before Vinodji concludes, I asked Hemanji, whom all you have contacted so far, put the names in the executive committee list. So I would request everybody who is present to at least persuade 5 people to apply for award.
Sir, Kothari sir, I would like to interrupt here. This is a webinar for the public who is interested in the webinar, and we will address your subjects maybe after the webinar. Thank you.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. But it is the persuasion after this webinar, the clarity has come. People should be able to persuade people to apply. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. On behalf of the awards committee, I would like to thank all the members who have participated in this webinar so actively, have been patient and listened to whatever we have had to present during the last 1 hour. It's been a long chat on the webinar. USCCI is yet getting used to these webinars, this platform. And I think the beginning has been made in a very emphatic manner with the guidance of President Kothari Sahab and the office bearers. I would like to, on behalf of the committee, Chairman Sri C.P. Talesa Sahab and myself, thank you all for making this happen, for allowing us to make this happen. I am very honored to congratulate Manishji Godha Sahab for making a very informative presentation on the jury process and being very clear and lucid in his explanation. There may be some questions which people on the webinar may not have understood because of the language of communication, which was English. If there is someone who wants any more clarity, chahe Hindi mein puchhein, chahe Angrezi mein puchhein, jaise aap chahein, hamare phone numbers available hain, aur main aapko ek bar hamare numbers fir se bata deta hoon. Shri CP Saab ka number hai 98290.
We would put that on chat.
We are putting those numbers on the chat window, and anyone who wants to access us, he can feel free and contact us directly. Otherwise, the secreted numbers, etc., have all been put up in the mailers, and you are free to please contact us. We would try to attend to your queries, maybe even beyond the normal working hours, 9 to 6. Do not worry about that. We will get back to you if we are not able to take your call in some particular time. With this, with the permission of Chairman Sri C.P. Talesa Sahab, may I bring this webinar to a close, sir?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for participating, and thanks for your questions.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
was with what, and without any prior.